My name is Patty Lopez. I'm an accounting professor at Valencia College and a digital faculty consultant for McGraw Hill Higher Education. During my 20 years of teaching managerial accounting, I have constantly looked for ways to incorporate Excel into my class. I know how important Excel knowledge is to my students' education and their future careers. Unfortunately, many students lack basic Excel skills. I don't have time to teach them those skills, and the consideration of manually grading Excel projects is also an issue. Therefore, I'm very excited to have partnered with McGraw-Hill on their development of a new auto-graded simulated Excel question type. This question is going to be assignable within Connect Accounting, just like every other homework, and it's going to be available for fall use. There will be one question per chapter with the Garrison, Brewer, and Noreen franchise. This example is from the Job Order Costing chapter. In each chapter, students will be building their Excel skills in the context of managerial accounting. As you look at the problem, you can see that it looks just like Excel and it acts just like Excel, but it is a simulation. Therefore, students do not have to have access to Excel in order to complete this question type. I would like to demo this one for you from the viewpoint of a student. As a student, I can see that the first input required is actual manufacturing overhead cost and that amount is $302,750. If I type that in, however, I'm going to be told that I'm incorrect because I must use formulas or cell references in order to get credit for the cell. Notice as I move through the spreadsheet, I get immediate feedback for each cell, whether I'm right or whether I'm wrong. What if I come up on a cell and I'm not sure what to do? Well, there are two types of optional help available. I say optional because you as the instructor determine whether or not these are turned off or on. The first is a hint.
The predetermined overhead rate is calculated using estimated manufacturing overhead cost and labor hours.
So the hint gives me some idea of what belongs in this cell, but it doesn't tell me how to input that information. What if I'm one of those students that does not have basic Excel knowledge? Then I can try show me.
Type equals E5 divided by E6 and press enter.
So show me actually shows me the formula that belongs in the cell, but once I see it, it goes away and I have to input it myself in order to get credit for the cell. In addition to the hints and show me, I can also see how many attempts I have available for each cell and how many are still available. This is something else that you as the instructor controls, how many attempts are allowed per cell. The default is 3. If I get my first attempt wrong, and I get my second attempt wrong, I get a warning that I have one more attempt available. If I get my final attempt wrong, a couple of things happen. First of all, I no longer have access to the cell. However, I'm not prevented from continuing with the spreadsheet. The correct answer, as well as the correct formula, appears, and I can continue. The system is very user-friendly, so as long as I input a valid formula, order doesn't matter. If I want to type, I can type. If I want to point and click, I can do that as well. As I work my way through the spreadsheet, I can move around. I can work out of order if I like. For example, if I wanted to input my direct labor before I calculated my materials, I can do that. And remember, as I work through, I get that immediate feedback. So if I do make a mistake, I have an opportunity to correct my mistake before I continue. Now I need my total raw materials available. There are a few different ways that a total can be input into Excel. As long as I do something that is valid, I will be correct. And as an aside, for those students who are learning how to use Excel, show me changes from chapter to chapter, so students will be shown different ways to write formulas and different ways to make cell references. Now I need to deduct my raw materials inventory ending. Since it's a deduction, I can input it as a positive. I can also input it as a negative, and my show me adjusts accordingly.
Type equals E36 plus E37 and press enter.
When I'm finished with my assignment, I submit it for grading, just like any other Connect assignment. Of course, you as an instructor control how many attempts the student has, not just per cell, but for the spreadsheet. You control how many points it's worth and when students can see their reports with their answers and the correct answers. In this case, I earned 3.75 out of 10. And when I look at my report, I see what I got correct and what I got incorrect or left blank. Remember, I input the actual direct labor hours incorrectly. Even though the simulation input the correct answer, when I see my report, it shows me that I got that cell wrong and what my wrong input was. So, as you see, students have the ability to practice their Excel skills. If necessary, they can learn some Excel skills. They can complete Excel projects that are graded for you automatically. So all of this can be incorporated into your class with no work on your part. I'm very excited to use it in my classes this fall, and I hope you are too. Thank you for your time, and if you have additional questions, please contact your rep.